Supplement 2, cracking gel. But what if you do have colonies on the Vectoplas insert plate, but they don't carry the clones that you want? For example, you have 16 colonies on Vectoplas insert and 12 colonies on the control. You mini-prepped and tested a few of them, but didn't find the right construct. With the cracking gel, you can screen several dozen colonies in less than an hour and know if any of them has a desired clone. Here is the protocol for making a cracking buffer and for the cracking gel procedure. Notice that this protocol is not in the protocol list, so if you would like to use it, pause the video and copy it from the screen. Right here on the bench I have a plate with 18 colonies that I am going to screen by a cracking gel. I also have a replica plate, a tube with a cracking buffer, 18 new Eppendorf tubes, double distilled water, gel loading dye with bromophenol blue, and a tube with a mini prep of parental plasmid, in this case PSAT6MCS, that will serve as a control. Let's move on to the cracking gel protocol itself. I start by adding to each of the tubes 20 microliters of water. In tube 1, which will serve as a control, I will put 1 microliter of parental plasmid, PSAT6MCS. In the rest of the tubes I will transfer the colonies by picking them with pipette tips, dipping the tips in the tubes with 20 microliters of water and leaving them in the tubes for the moment. Once all the tips are in the corresponding tubes, I shake off the cells by vortexing the tubes at low speed with the tips inside. Then I remove each tip and touch the labeled replica plate. I will keep this plate at 37 degrees overnight. Once all the cells are in, I am going to lyse them by adding 20 microliters of the cracking buffer to each of the tubes. Notice that there is no mixing involved at this step. I immediately proceed with adding 20 microliters of loading dye with bromophenol blue and glycerol. I load contents of each of the tubes on a 0.7% agarose gel and run it for 1 hour at 105 volts. Notice that for the cracking gel, I'm using a 0.7% agarose, which allows for better separation of large DNA fragments. Let's look at the picture of this gel. Since we run the whole cell lysates here, we can see three types of nucleic acids. RNA is that big smear at the bottom. At the very top is genomic DNA. And the plasmids we are looking for are in the middle. In the control lane, you can see how the vector would run if it didn't have an insert. Out of the 18 colonies that we are screening here, only plasmids from colonies 6 and 14 run higher than the control, which means they should have the insert that we are trying to introduce. On the next day, we can go back to the replica plate and start the mini prep cultures with clones 6 and 14.